Paul Cullen. Unplugged and uncorked. We're going to talk to him a little bit more here in just a little bit. Well, you know, before you know it, it's going to be springtime. It's going to be time for that spring cleaning. Mm-hmm. That means we're going to have to pull out all the cleaning supplies, the bleaches, the disinfectants.
But it's important to remember safety first when it comes to the chemicals and the toxins. Joining us today to talk about this is Dr. Patrick Dougherty, Assistant Professor of Pharmacy Practice at University of Maryland Eastern Shore. Welcome to Del Mar.
Thank you for having me.
Thanks for joining us. Now, we all know that cleaning products are dangerous and you really need to keep them away from children. Mm-hmm. But is there really anything childproof?
There really isn't. Most people think that medication vials and containers are childproof when in fact they're actually child resistant. If you give a toddler or a small child enough time to get into this bottle, they'll find a way to get into it.
Wow.
So they'll find a way to get in there, mm-hmm. one way or the other. So is there anything in particular we should try to do to store this stuff to try to make sure the kids can't get to it?
You should keep chemicals and potential hazardous materials out of reach of children, mm-hmm. in locked containers as best as possible.
I guess one of the reasons we're in the kitchen set is because this is where we keep most of our stuff, is,
yeah.
is under the
most
kitchen
Most people
cabinet.
Think under the kitchen sink is
yeah.
the best
yeah,
place to keep
yeah.
them.
Yeah, that's probably not a good place.
Probably not, unless you can keep that locked up.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And you get those little latches to keep the door closed. Mm-hmm. Is that a good idea?
It's okay. a possible good idea with an alarm to it as well.
Oh, okay.
I didn't even think about those when my kids were little. Didn't even think
Interesting.
About that.
All right, so as far as cleaning and supplies, it's important to know that they stay in their original containers too. I know sometimes people will transfer.
Right, if you have a large container of a hazardous substance or an automotive product per se, you want to put it into a smaller container like a drinking bottle, and it's not labeled as that, somebody may mistake that as, oh, a sports drink, I'm thirsty, and potentially cause some injury.
It's
yeah.
You know, it's funny you should say that, because I'm looking at this one and this looks almost identical to a sports
Absolutely.
Drink that
yep.
I like.
This looks a lot like
apple juice.
Yeah, indeed.
And I think that I have some cleaner that is purple.
Yeah.
Yeah, because it has the lavender, you know, mm-hmm. the lavender smell and everything. So it's
grape flavored, right?
Grape flavored.
That's what people would think
right.
if it's in a drinking container.
Very interesting.
Is there anything we can do to try to keep the smaller kids who maybe can't read, you know, poison? Is there something we can do to keep them off? Is it just, does it boil down to us storing it right and keeping an eye on them?
It does, and teaching small children to always ask first before touching or putting something into their mouth.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Good stuff to know. Is there anything that you can think of that, you know, you just don't need to have in your house, period, as far as toxins? I mean,
it's hard to say. As long as everything is stored properly and kept out of way and used safely, one of the most important things to do is always read the labels for whatever product you're working with. And that will help you with storing it properly and using it properly.
Okay.
I guess keep a number handy for the poison control.
Yeah,
absolutely. 1-800-222-1222. Toll-free number for your local poison control center. Open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. They can answer any questions you have about poison safety.
All gotcha. Right. Thank you so much, you Patrick. Go. And for a list of these safety tips, go to delmarvalife.com and click on the show tab. Well, next on Del Marva Life, photography these days is so much more than a pretty picture.
Yeah. How about with all of the technology and tools, photography, that can really turn into works of art like this? Local artist behind this photography joins us next on Del Marva Life.